Hi, I'm JB Friday, Extension Forester with the University of Hawaii. We're here on another virtual field day for forestry in Hawaii.
And I'm Steve Coffey, Senior Environmental Educator with Educational Solutions here on the Big Island.
We're here today to talk about planting forestry trees. And the key thing about planting forestry trees, whether it's for production forestry or for conservation forestry, is to get a lot of trees in the ground and do it quickly and efficiently, but making sure the trees survive. So today we'll walk through the steps in doing that. So Steve, what do we have set up here?
We have the basic tools needed for a day of planting in the field mm-hmm. with some simple seedlings. The first step is to get a hole into the ground, and we use this dibble, provided that we're using seedlings in dibble tubes. You can see the shape is the exact mm-hmm. same.
Okay.
So it's a quick and easy way to make a perfect size and shape hole. If the substrate is a little more rocky or lava, we get the hole started with
the oval bar.
And then we can come behind and fine-tune the shape with our dibble. We also use, what do we call this, Jamie?
Hori knife.
We use the hori knife to supplement and fine-tune the planting hole. Sometimes mm-hmm. after we get the seedling in the ground, we can snug it in using this tool. I like to carry two buckets into the field. One is the wet bucket, half full of water, where my seedlings are soaking and get the root ball nice and wet. And I've got a cup in here to pour a big amount of water on the plant after it goes into the ground, and one dry bucket to put our empty dibble tubes and to carry some fertilizer around in as we move through the field. And that's the basic tools we need to in a typical planting situation.
Okay, sounds good.
All right.
When you plant trees, any kind of forest trees, into a pasture like this, it's important to control the grasses before you start planting. Otherwise, the grasses will swamp the trees and outcompete them. In this site, we controlled grasses by spraying with herbicides. It was a fairly thick mat of kukuyu grass. What did you spray here, Steve?
We sprayed here about 2.5 weeks ago with a combination of glyphosate and imazapyr.
So the glyphosate gives you a quick takedown. Imazapyr is a much longer lasting herbicide.
Indeed.
And
it was a good combo for a quick preparation.
This also was grazed down. The grass was grazed fairly low before you sprayed. How tall was the grass before you came in here?
When I first came in here, the grass was easily up to my waist, and there's no way to work in that grass. So I arranged with the rancher to get the cattle in here before our project started. And within a week, they had the grass down to maybe a foot tall. Mm-hmm. And then I could apply the herbicide a little more effectively and lay out the rows for planting.
Sounds good. The seedlings we're planted today are koa seedlings. They were grown by Jill Wagner at Future Forest Nurseries in Kailua-Kona on the island of Hawaii. These are good seedlings. The root to shoot ratio is appropriate, about that much root for about that much shoot. In Hawaii, we always plant containerized seedlings, so these are grown in root trainers, dibble tubes. On the tubes here, the seedlings come out easily for planting. They also train the roots, so the roots go straight down. And you can see the tree comes out in a solid plug here. This makes it easy to plant.
Koa is a nitrogen-fixing tree, and the bacteria that fix the nitrogen live in nodules attached to the roots of the seedlings. If you cut open one of these nodules, you should see a healthy pink inside, as in this photo. If the nodules are white inside, or brown or black, then they're either dead or not actively fixing nitrogen.
This site turned out to be pretty rocky, so we're digging our holes with the OO bar this time. I put a piece of tape on this OO bar to gauge how deep to thrust it into the ground so my hole's not too deep and it's not too shallow. So I'm just going to thrust it down here. I hit a bit of a rock, so I'll just move over a couple inches and found a soft spot. It went in just the right depth up to my tape line. That hole's ready, and I can move on to the next one. I've marked my OO bar with this tape so I can thrust it into the exact depth. It's the same depth as one dibble, the dibble that I'm planting, to make sure that my hole is not too deep and not too shallow. Also, to gauge the hole, sometimes I just insert a stack of dibble tubes to see if I'm at the right depth, and it also helps to form the hole a little bit rounder to match the exact shape of my root ball when we drop it into the hole.
When we're planting the tree, In this project, we're using about 5 grams of fertilizer. Here we have an Osmocote triple 14, so it's coated slow release. Put it in the bottom of the hole. I like to knock a little soil on top of that so the roots aren't directly in contact with it. Form the hole again with the old dibble tubes. Ease the seedling out of the dibble tube. So these, since they've been soaked in water here, they came out quite easily. Slide it in the hole. When we slide it in the hole, we want to firm up the soil around the dibble tube. You use a trowel. I like using the Hori knife. And we just jam it in to close up the bottom of the hole. The important thing is to make sure there are no air pockets in the bottom of the hole and that the roots have good contact with the soil. The other important thing is to make sure the roots are straight down in there and don't J-rote, so they don't bend around as they hit the bottom of the soil. You want to plant the seedling so the soil surface and the root color of the seedling are at the soil surface where you're planting. You don't want it down too far or up too high. So this seedling is planted exactly the right depth. This seedling was planted too shallow, not deep enough in the soil, so this top portion of the roots that are sticking out, these will dry out quickly and that will kill the seedling. So this seedling won't survive. This hole was dug too deep. You can see here the stem of the tree would be covered by several inches of soil. If this happens, the stem will be rotten and the seedling will die. So this hole needs to be filled in somewhat more. Here we put a little more soil in the hole, and there it's just at the right depth.
At planting, we give each seedling about a liter of water to get it started.
Here we are back in Kaiholena in February. That's 3 months after we initially planted the trees. It's been a good rainy 3 months. You can see that the grass is nice and green. However, our weed control has worked well, and in this plot, we have good weed control. The koa trees are off to a healthy start, and we've had 85% survival so far. For the weed control on this plot, we've used a combination of the herbicides glyphosate and imazapyr. Glyphosate gives you a quick takedown of grasses, but the effects usually wear off after about 6 months. If this had just been sprayed by glyphosate, the grasses would have started coming back by now. Imazapyr is a slower acting but longer acting herbicide, and you can see 6 months after application, the weeds are completely dead and we have no competition for our koa trees. We're applying 3 ounces of a coated triple 13 with micros fertilizer to each tree. The coated fertilizer is a slow release. 3 months after planting here, these trees are off to a good start, and we're broadcasting fertilizer. We're not worrying about the fertilizer helping the grass grow and promoting weeds because the herbicide treatment has kept the grass competition down. So we're just broadcasting 3 ounces of our fertilizer on each tree here. What's going to happen now is that the trees are going to hit the summer with a lot of fertilizer with no weed competition. We expect they'll take off.